Sorry about that, folks. Part two. So I was saying, why am I not buying this Sir Jacques Well pipe? I said, there's no reason why I'm not buying it. I should buy this pipe. So I bought this pipe. You know, look at the grain on top. Look at the sandblast on top of this goofy thing. Look at that. It's got sandblast on the side. And I just, it's a weird pipe. I don't know that I wanted, this is called a horn. I don't know that I wanted a horn, but it's got the same saddle bit that I'm in love with, you know, and it's got the sandblast. I wish you could see how good this looks, you know, in real life. It's so beautiful. So I bought this pipe, and I really could not afford it. It was a stupid thing to do, really, but I just bought it anyway. I've got a case of the PAD going these days, and it smokes wonderfully. It's got a big air opening. You know, very nice. It's weird because the tobacco, it goes in like this at an angle, like this. So when you tamp it down, you don't tamp it flat. You tamp it like this. At least I do anyway, because if you don't, it gets kind of weird. You got to kind of tamp it how it goes in a little bit. But it's a nice pipe. I thought it might be too big for me, but, you know, really, it's not. See here. You know, it's not too big. You know, it fits me perfectly. I grab the top here like this with my hand, was how I grab them. You know, it's perfect for me. It's nice. So I was looking for different pipe, actually, though. I was looking for this pipe here when I bought this one. It just serves me right for going online and looking around anyway. I was looking for another Casello, and I found this one here. I wanted a Dublin pipe. Being a majority of being Irish-American, I consider myself just an American, but I am quite Irish, actually, and some English, a lot of English, too. I wanted a Dublin pipe for a long time. I also just think this is just an absolutely gorgeous shape for a pipe. I don't know about you, but I just love the whole thing up here. I love the, just, I just think it's absolutely beautiful, this kind of pipe. I've seen a bunch of them online, and I finally found this one. The secondhand smoker had this one. I bought this from the secondhand smoker. Pretty good guy, nice dealer. And then he had this one here, too, later on. I twisted the poor guy's arm and begged him to sell it to me for cheaper than it was, because it was the best offer pipe, and he was, you know, gratefully, he was pretty good about it. He didn't, you know, I'm surprised he didn't piss him off. But I bought this pipe. This was the last pipe that I bought. Well, actually, I have a pipe coming, as a matter of fact, tomorrow, which I bought another pipe, not too expensive. But as you see in my collection, I don't have a lot of pipes, you know, because I'll tell you a little funny story. When I was a child, my dad collected knives, pocket knives and things. And I got into collecting pocket knives, knives of all kinds. And so I had this 100 or 200 pocket knives and knives of various kinds and sheath knives and things. And when I was like in my 20s and I had a little antique store, a guy came in one day and we were talking about collecting things, and he said he'd love to see my collection. So I brought them down for him to look at. He was a knife collector, and I hadn't collected knives for a few years, but I spread them all out on my glass case and was showing my collection, which I kind of liked. And he says, "Oh, you've got a lot of knives, but you don't have anything really very high quality, do you?" And I was shocked. I was taken aback. I was a little insulted, you know. And he saw it in my face, and I was shocked. And he said, I don't mean to insult you. I'm not trying to insult you. I don't mean to be mean. It's just that none of your pipes are handmade. I mean, none of your knives are handmade. They're all just factory-produced knives, and a lot of them are from India and stuff. And just, they were all cheap knives. And there were some switchblades in there and things, I suppose. And they were all just cheap knives. And I realized he was absolutely right. And the knives, none of them were really very high quality. So I sold my entire collection off in a bunch, which I wish I hadn't done now. Some of those, which I kind of had memories of them, but I sold them all off. And I put the money into my very first handmade, high-quality knife. It was actually a Randall knife, as a matter of fact. And I have had Randalls off and on since then, but never more than a couple, because I can't afford to have a collection of damn things. They're too expensive. So when I decided to start collecting pipes and get serious about pipe collecting, after this one here, my thoughts were, rather than buy, you know, cheap pipes, you know, maybe I and buy a lot of them. And I'm not saying this is the right way to do it, by the way. Don't mistake me. I'm not saying you should do this, because this is just my thought. I thought to myself, rather than buy, you know, a lot of pipes, a lot of estate pipes, and have a whole big collection of pipes, my thought was to buy only pipes I absolutely am in love with. And when I see a pipe like this, and when I saw this pipe here, I mean, something went off in my brain that it's hard to describe. I mean, that's my policy on eBay anyway, is to only buy those things which I just go, I gotta have that. And that's what this was, you know, and that is what this was, you know, and that's what this was. It wasn't like, you know, oh, there's a pipe, I'll just buy it. I mean, you know, I don't care. They are more a little more expensive, but I only buy estate pipes that are in extremely good condition. And that I have certain parameters of what I will and will not buy. And again, I just, you know, I'm just, I gotta have that pipe, you know, that's what it's like, you know, for me. That's what I'm doing. That's, you know, and that's when I'll buy a pipe. You know, right now I'm bought out pretty much. I can't, I, you know, I still wouldn't mind having more pipes, but I'm having to sell off some of my knife collection, current knife collection, just to do that because I'm really overspent and I've really done a bad thing. So anyway, that's my pipe collection. One more little thing about this pipe that kind of weirded me out at first. I don't know if you can see this, but can you see right there? Can you see that? Can I get that on the camera for you? Can you see that? I'll do it from this side, right in front of my index finger. Can you see that? It looks like a little round eyeball. At first, I thought, "Oh my God, there's an imperfection in my pipe. It looks like someone had drilled it, or some tool market, you know, made a funny little swirl there, you know." I thought, "Oh my God, this has got a flaw in it, you know," which wouldn't be the worst thing, but it's like, gee, what it is though is on the front of this pipe. There's all it, the way the grain is. That's the end of the grain, and this was, I don't know, it's where a limb came out or what the deal is. Probably not, but that's just where the grain is, and it actually looks like an eyeball. It's very strange, actually. It's kind of creepy looking. I don't like to look at it very much because I'm like. Like looking at it going, it's, my pipe is staring back at me. So I try not to look at it very much, but it's kind of cool though in a way. And again, you know, look at the grain in these pipes. So that's my pipe collection. That's how I roll, you know. I'm not saying it's how you should roll, but you know, I only have four pipes that I actually smoke. And you're looking at them right now. That's the four pipes that I smoke right there, you know. You know, a little Bulldog, a Dublin. You know, my whatever that is, and my horn. You know, I only smoke those pipes. But I only smoke them, you know, maybe once a day. So, you know, one pipe a day, probably maybe two. Although the other night I smoked three different pipes in one night. So I clean them very well when they're done. I take very good care of these pipes. They have to last me a lifetime. And I'm sure I'll have more. I've got a new one coming right now in the mail. In fact, actually, you know what? I bought a pipe on eBay that was unsmoked. So technically, it's the first new pipe I have bought in 30 years. It's the first new pipe, and it's a James Upshaw, and I'll be showing that here one of these days here. But it's the first new one in 30 years. I actually was able to afford a new pipe. It's not a real fancy pipe, but it is something I've wanted for a long time. It's not in the order of these, and not these crazy looking, you know, shapes, you know, that I like, you know. It's actually a shame. James Upshaw shall love it, but I do have a love for that shape too, and billiards too. I'd like to have a billiard someday. There they are. People ask what kind of pipes I've got, what kind of pipes am I smoking, and that's them. I like fairly large pipes. I wish this one here had been a lot larger, as a matter of fact, but you can't win them all, you know. This he clearly represented the size. I just thought in my dog brain that it was larger somehow. So. There you go. Keep looking at the time to see what time we're going here. That's my collection, meager as it is. You know, I like to. I would like. I mean, if I were rich, I would have a big chest of drawers with hundreds of pipes in them. I mean, I would be so nuts for pipes. I'd be so crazy for pipes. It'd be like people be going, "What's wrong with this guy? You know, he's nuttier than a fruitcake." You know, I'd have hundreds and hundreds of pipes. Hundreds of pipes I've never smoked before. You know, whole nine yards. It'd be crazy, crazy time. Crazy time. Anyway, there you go, folks. Have a good night, guys. If I can close this one somehow, here you go.